Naomba ni wapate wote wazima wa afya na wenye furaha. Mimi ni PTRLM Tumizulu wa Marifado. Uhindi ni bara la pili baada ya Afrika. Kwa sababu hiyo tutaingalia kwa umakini. Black India's history is being revised. Why is it being slowly but surely reworked? Who is behind these revisions? In times gone by, the indigenous melanin-dominant humans in India will eventually be forgotten, as is the memory that India was once known as Eastern Ethiopia or Kush. Kush is spread in Bantu Chikaranga tongue. Memory of the most ancient inhabitants of India will be replaced by another fake paradigm, where questions like who first discovered India, who rules India, how did this happen, will all be answered differently from true history. Cultural unity is our power to survive. There was no country known as India 5,000 years BCE. Even the name Hindu is Ethiopian. Ancient records of authority made Hind and Sindh sons of Kush. Philostratus in Vit Apollon Lib 2 says, the Ind is the wisest of mankind. The Ethiopians are a colony of them, and they inherit the wisdom of their fathers. The separation of India from the parent Kushite stock was in ages long before the rise of the so-called Aryans in India. The older Greeks always associated the sacred waves of the Indian Ocean with the wonderful Ethiopians. Ephoras said that they occupied all the southern coasts of Asia and Africa. Before we show the architects of the revisions, let us summarize very important themes. Who is indigenous in India? It is a Muntu. When did they arrive in India and how? They arrived in India by two obvious means, by tectonic continental ride, as well as a second wave of normal human migration. 3 billion years ago, humans had already started to manufacture complicated metals. These are the clectop metals or clectop spheres or balls, which were extracted out of a deep rock at the Wonderstone silver mine in South Africa, averaging about 4 inches in diameter and composed of a nickel steel alloy that does not exist in nature. It's man-made. So in Africa, humans were already there 3 billion years ago. Pale skin, we know now from genetics studies, only appeared 8,500 years ago, which means in India, the indigenous people in India were melanin-dominant people. That cannot be denied. There they are. The Harappan civilization was not Aryan. It was a melanin-dominant human civilization, a Bantu civilization. They named themselves and gave the names Hindu Kush there because they are the owners of the land. Stone tools found in India resemble those in Africa, changing the theory of human migration. You can study that in newsweek.com. A recent survey in India and a dig in India has uncovered stone tools and weapons and other artifacts made by early humans, which resemble tools found in Eastern and Southern Africa. There is also the Aryan invasion of India, or Aryan invasion of India, which is shown here. This is the tectonic plates and the movement which proves that India moved away from Africa to join the subcontinent of Asia there. There it is. And Indo-African tribal people also moved into India and many other islands, as well as the invasion that occurred by the Aryans here. India's history is built and must be understood from the Aryan invasion theme. There it is shown here. Now, it is very clear that the Aryan invasion involved a race of people that moved from Central and from Europe and Central Asia, Aryans, and swept into the subcontinent, displacing indigenous people of India across the four rivers down to the south and the islands. The Indians today, particularly Hindus, have always been rather schizoid on the subject of the Aryan invasion. Many argue that the Aryans came as migrants, which is a lie. They were invaders. And of course, because Hindus are mainly mulattoes or colors or mixed between the Aryans as well as the Dravidians and the indigenous melanin-dominant humans of India, they feel loyalty to both. So that's how it is. But there is a move today for revisionism and attacks on the Aryan invasion theory. To the contrary, there is a lot of evidence and proof that the Aryans indeed invaded and destroyed the indigenous black civilizations in India. In part two of this series on India, we shall present more proof and evidence of the Harappan civilization and how it was destroyed by the Aryans, and the proof of the Aryans themselves, whom we are showing here. The Aryan race is a historical fact, as Indo-Europeans and their heritage, and there's a group of their heritage. It's a fact that they exist. All of them are shown here. Aryans means Iranian, which is close to the Hindu Kush Mountains as well as the Caucasus Mountain. Who are the people doing the revisionism? We've got a book here by Dr. Uthaya Naidu, The Bible of Aryan Invasions. It's very difficult to get this book, but you can search and find it and buy it and own it. It's not a very big book. It's a very tiny book, but it's packed with dynamite. You can also send us an email and we can share a free PDF of this book from a blog where we subscribe. Aryan invasion deniers in recent years have, with considerable vociferous movement, completely continue to pump propaganda purporting there was no Aryan invasion or Aryan invasions. This brand actually denies at greatest length the notion of any Aryan invasion, a single invasion. Even physical facts are distorted and twisted and denied and panel beaten to fit with their fanciful concepts. These are the ones that are revising India's history. We shall show them very, very shortly. Another fraud perpetrated by these scholars is to perpetually claim that their theory of denying an Aryan invasion is new. It is not new. Indeed, the traditional Vaishnava Puranic view, which is supported by all the six orthodox schools of Brahminism, is that the Aryas migrated from Ayavata in Bharat and then spread all across the world. Moreover, ever since the discovery of non-Aryan Harappan civilization, the Aryans have been inventing wild and fantastic theories denying the invasion by Aryans of India. So, but when they invaded, they found our sophisticated brothers already there practicing their belief system and way of life. So these are all taken from Bantu. I'm going to prove it now. Canada, it means Canada. Canada, if I want. Science of logic and futility of Maya. It says Vaisheshika, Vaishashika. In other words, they put it out to the sun to observe it and to dry it. Nyaya, it's story. Yoga means alone. Senkaya means you are at home thinking about Ekaya. Vedanta means those who think and want to find nature, the soul of nature in the world. Mimansa is the ways of the sun. So these are the periods of the development of this philosophy. You can see it starts 1500, but we have already proved that there was already human beings on Earth 3 billion years ago. So the Vedic period, that's 1500 to 600 BCE. So it's too young. It's too young for us to consider here. There are several things to notice regarding the background of the scholars who propound these negationist theories. They are all Brahmins. A Brahmi is a Hindu priest caste, one of the four Varanas or social groups based on occupation in ancient Hindu society. The caste system is proof of the Aryan invasion theory. It's a new system and it puts black people in an apartheid cluster. Just like apartheid, the caste system has found its inroads into India, Bhutan, Nepal, all in South Asia. Although progressive-minded Hindus claim they are free of this social evil, it is still practiced covertly and overtly. Discrimination on the basis of caste or untouchability would include the practice of banishing entry of sudras into the so-called higher caste homes and an obsession with supremacy of birth, which still continues unabated today. And you want to tell us that there is no and there was no Aryan invasion. You can tell that to others, not to people that are wide awake. This is the untouchables, our brothers and sisters, Bantus, melanin-dominant humans that are put under and are never considered anyway. And they are street sweepers, Latin and toilet cleaners, cobblers, the manual work, and sometimes they are just killed for nothing and abused and pushed into poverty by economic policies. Shudras, servants, subordinates to Vaishavas, Kshatriyas, and Brahmins. So these are not even allowed to rise to there. It's locked. And these are known as twice-born groups, the privileged ones, the divine ones. So this is there. This is proof. There is another a scholar here. We give a number of scholars here. Madravayo Dadashvrayo Golwaka, popularly known as Guruji. Sasang Chakalak, Supreme Chief of the National Volunteer Organization, an Indian right-wing Hindu nationalist paramilitary volunteer organization. This is the man denying the Aryan invasion too, and is loved by the current Prime Minister of India. Here is what he said. To keep up the purity of the nation and its culture, Germany shocked the world by ravaging the country of Semitic races, the Jews. National pride at its highest has been manifested here. Germany has also shown how well nigh impossible it is for races and cultures having differences going to the root to be assimilated into one united whole. A good lesson for us in Hindustan, that's his name for India, to learn and profit by. So you can see that he is a denier. Again, these are all deniers, these of Aryan invasion theory, all of these, including the current Prime Minister, who writes about Golwaka in his essay entitled Pujaniya Shri Guruji. Guru is, means worth of worship. So he worshipped that man, Golwaka. And he suggested that Golwaka is second only to Vivekanand, who is the first. All deniers of Aryan invasion theory on the life of the Prime Minister of India. That's what he says. He says a Prime Minister of India should believe in these people and follow these people and love these people. That's what he says. He writes admiringly of the ease with which Golwaka took life decisions. So, he, like decisions, that caste system must continue. That's what he is propagating, but he's doing it in a very sly and subtle manner. Again, throwing his weight behind the Aryan project by Delhi University Sanskrit Department, noted American scholar David Frawley, said there is a need for an extensive new Vedic study and insisted that Aryans were indigenous to India. That is a lie. It's not 80,000 years before him. And actually, his roots are 3 billion years before him. This man and the combination of him and him produced the current mulattoes in India. It's a fact. It cannot be denied. So another one is Prankois Gotia, who said there is a modern threat to Hinduism, which is modern threat to India. Why is he? Why are there scholars like that? Most European scholars, as well as those in India, who deny the Aryan invasion theory, suffer from a guilty complex. Since crimes on the indigenous melanin-dominant Indians were also perpetrated by white-skinned Caucasians that look like them. It's a brother to brother, sister to sister, kin to kin. So they support their kin that way by denying it. So the indigenous Aryanism, also known as the indigenous Aryan theory, and the out-of-India theory, is the conviction that the Aryans are indigenous to Indian subcontinent, which is a lie. They are not. They have never been indigenous there. There is an explanation that can be given for how they could be indigenous, but they are secondary. It's the pyramid turns the other way around. The discovery of the Indus Valley civilization in the 1920s brought to light a suppressed chapter of Indian history, namely the large-scale destruction and the genocide perpetrated over 1,000 years by the Aryan invaders on indigenous owners of India who looked like this. The indigenous owners were the Negroid Sudras, and the Mongoloids who were dark, melanin dominant, and the Semites who are now the bridge between the current people and the new caste of mulattoes that are there today. However, this episode is blatantly denied by the Brahmin-controlled press of India, which propagates highly distorted versions of history and even goes to the extent of denying that any genocide took place. Such distortion of history leads to the continuation of crimes against humanity. As promised, in part two, we will supply more proof of the genocide and continuous destruction, physically and otherwise, of our brothers and sisters in the subcontinent of Africa, now called India instead of Kush. If you want more sources and evidence, you can email us on join@marifado.com. What can you do? Marifado is your heritage too. Together as melanin-dominant humans, we must work for unity and unite. It is our culture, our identity, and we invoke the Ubuntu Mahati spirit. You request any free literature, ask us any questions to help us, as well as get more information, send your email to join@marifado.com. This is Preacher Rabbi L.M. Dumizulu saying, we are rebuilding our greatness. Subscribe to our channel, Hamit Hebrew Ethics. Share this channel. Check that you are still subscribed, as well as the notice is still going on by clicking the bell. Let us walk this journey together until we meet again in part two of this very important topic. Salani kahle, asante sana, sarai jaganaka, edupe, siabonga, henkos.